The I-75 bridge between Ohio and Kentucky is actually older than the one that collapsed in Minneapolis. We've seen plans to replace the Brent Spence, but nothing's going to happen without any money. Congresswoman Jean Schimdt joins us tonight from Washington to talk about the bridge project. And Ms. Schmidt, you're on the Transportation Committee. What's being done right now to try to push this project through?
Well, I think that in the next few months, you're going to hear a lot on the Transportation Committee about bridges in general in the United States, considering Chairman Obestar is from Minnesota. But this particular project has already been brought to their attention by my predecessor, Rob Portman, as well as myself. And I continue to push forward as we move towards our next comprehensive transportation bill, which will be coming in about 3 years, to make sure that we have the necessary funding in place from the federal end to indeed build a new bridge.
And will an incident like the one in Minnesota make it more urgent to get funding to everyone, or will so much money be set aside for Minneapolis to rebuild that we can't get the needed funding?
Well, I think it can be a mixed effort of what you're saying. We've currently today authorized $250 million to Minnesota to rebuild their bridge. But having said that, we set aside $2 billion every year for emergency repairs for bridges across the United States. The next comprehensive transportation bill will address things like needed bridge repairs across the United States, and I want to make sure that the Brent Spence Bridge is one of those bridges that will be in that bill, which is why I'm working with Congressman Shabbat and Congressman Davis and the folks in the greater Cincinnati, northern Kentucky area, as well as the state of Ohio, to make sure that this happens.
Bottom line this for us, if you will. When can your constituents here in the tri-state expect you to announce that our funding is ready?
Well, I think that's going to be several years out, since this Congress only looks at comprehensive bridge structures like the Brent Spence project every 5 years. And we passed the last bill 2.5 years ago. So we're 2.5 years into the next comprehensive bill, which would allow for a major overhaul of that dimension. We're talking about a $3 billion project. We have 250+ thousand bridges across the United States. 75,000 of those are in the classification of the Minnesota Bridge, which is something that is in desperate need of repair. 79,000 are classified like the Brent Spence Bridge, which says that they are just over capacity. There's no serious structural damage or issues related to it. It's just a matter of capacity. So we've got a whole lot of bridges that need to be addressed across the nation, but I'm going to be pushing forward to make sure that our bridge is on top of that list.
All right, and we know you've had a busy day already. Congresswoman Jean Schimdt, we appreciate you joining us from Washington tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.